But today I am at my church and I am going to be painting a mural. It's an 8 feet by 8 feet wall. And it's going to be it's basically mural size. And they are using it for a photo booth backdrop for Mother's Day this Sunday. And so they wanted someone to paint a floral type background. So that's what I'm doing. I'm using the canvases they already had. They've used them before for different sets. So there's a lot of prep work involved, a lot of sanding and taking out staples and tape and whatnot. And I've primed it with 2 coats of just house paint. You can see them there. I'm going to be putting them together when I start actually painting it. And so that's what I'm doing here. I'm going to be recording myself as I paint, but I will put it into, you know, a time-lapse video, so it's not going to take forever because this is going to be a few days here. And I may come back and narrate a few things depending on what I feel when I go to edit this video. But I am going to be doing a more instructional video in next week on just different things, and I'm going to be doing kind of like a sample size of just to show you how I did this. And so you can be watching for that, and you can just watch the rest of this video, and I hope you enjoy it. I will also just mention that I am going to be showing you still photos after each stage that I've done, just so you can see a better close-up of images of what I've done, because it's hard to tell with the camera, and I just had to set up the camera and just leave it there and then zoom in, and with the exposure and everything, it's just hard to tell at times what it actually looks like that I'm painting, especially with these ink sprays that I'm working with right now. These are the ink sprays. All of these are the ones that I did with Sharpies, so they are my homemade alcohol inks, and check out my video for that. But yeah, they worked really well for this project, and I used a lot of them, and I just love how they turned out, so you'll have to make sure you check out the still photos that I have after this stage. done. I just have a few more things I want to do, and I think I'm going to put some, just to balance the green writing, I'm going to put something coming up on the bottom left, or not really bottom, but up from the bottom there in the center. And the biggest thing is just to figure out how to do the center, because it's not like a typical mural or painting, as I mentioned before, because it is a photo booth backdrop, so people are standing there. So I didn't want to leave it completely white, but I had to be, I have to consider, you know, the tones and stuff, because that's the background for the people. I think I'm going to add a little bit of warm green, soft warm green in the middle, just to make it kind of give it more, even more of a nature feel, like maybe you're in a garden or something. And if I don't like that, I can always paint over it in white and kind of start again, or just kind of keep working it until I'm happy with it. But anyways, this is basically done, so I'll let you watch the rest of this.